Lastly, number four in the understanding dunya is knowing how to succeed in this life, how to stay afloat in the ocean of dunya. Now, if you think about dunya as an ocean, if you go into the ocean with a boat, what happens if the boat lets the water in? You start to sink, right? Now, if you think about this life, the dunya, as an ocean, and think about the boat as your heart. As long as that boat stays on top of the water, on top of the dunya, on top of the ocean, and doesn't let the water in, it's fine. It stays floating and it's okay. But as soon as that boat allows water into it, that's when it sinks. And this is the same way with dunya. As soon as we let dunya into our hearts, and we start to become attached to dunya, and we start to love dunya, and dunya no longer is a means. Remember, we talked about the difference between means and end. When you make dunya your end, you will sink. It's just like a person who says, "The ocean is my end." What's going to happen to you if your ocean, if the ocean, where are you going? The ocean. That's where I'm going. That's my goal. If that's your end, you're going to sink. But if you use the ocean as a means, actually, I'm just passing through. I'm just passing through the ocean to get to the next continent, right? To get to the next place. That's how dunya is. We're just passing through it to get to the next place. But if we make it our end, we let it into our hearts, that's when we sink. Okay, number four in this recipe for success in this life and the next is plan for tomorrow. So as students, you guys think a lot about your future. It's natural. You think about, what am I going to do next year? What am I going to do after I graduate? What am I going to do with my career? These are all things that you think about. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا ربكم ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begins this ayah by telling us to have fear of Him. So Allah is addressing here those who believe. Allah addresses different people in the Quran. In this case, He's addressing the believers and He says, have taqwa of Allah, have fear of Allah. First advice. Second advice, وَلْتَنْظُرْ نَفْسٌ مَا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدْ. And let every nafs, every human being, every soul know what it has set forth for tomorrow. In this case, tomorrow, capital T. So we all spend our, you know, so much time planning on tomorrow. Tomorrow as in, you know, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, next year, next, you know, after I graduate. Allah here is telling us and reminding us, plan for the other tomorrow, the tomorrow after this life. And see what you're putting forth. Remember the example of the furniture? What are you, you want to be, you're going to this house. You know you're going to this house. Nobody can deny that you're going to this house. Furnish it. Furnish it. You know you're going to live there. So put, set things for, you know, like send provision so that when you get there, you're not starving, right? You wanna furnish that place. You wanna stock up the fridge because you know you're going there. You guys, it's a certainty. Nobody can deny it. We're all gonna die. We're all gonna go there. So set it up so that you, when you get there, you have something to live with, right? So here Allah is saying, out of His mercy, reminding us to look at what we've put forth for tomorrow. وَلْتَنْظُرْ نَفْسٌ مَا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدْ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. Allah again says in the end of the ayah, He again advises us to have taqwa of Allah. He begins the ayah with taqwa, ends the ayah with taqwa, and in the middle, He talks about, what are we putting forth for tomorrow? Look at what you're setting forth for tomorrow.